We turn now to the key part of the analysis, where we show that each phase of the Dinic algorithm takes v times e time. As with Edmonds Karp, we will use a level graph. In this case, however, the algorithm actually builds the graph, whereas in Edmonds Karp, we simply used it for the analysis. The level graph can be built by running breadth-first search and saving all forward edges while ignoring backwards and lateral ones. As we argued before, when we augment a flow along a path, say along this one here, we introduce reverse edges into the residual graph. Note that these are always backwards edges in the level graph, and hence they aren't useful in building a path equal to or shorter than the previous shortest path. Well, if the new edges are useless, why rebuild the level graph of the residual graph when the old one will serve just as well? We can just update the residual capacities. More precisely, given the possibly outdated level graph, we can build a path from source to sink just by making the first vertex on the adjacency list the next vertex in the path. If this generates a path to T, then we augment the flow and update the residual capacities. If it doesn't, then we delete the last vertex in the path from the level graph. In this example, we would first find a path from S to T, and let's say that this edge here is a bottleneck. Its capacity gets set to 0, and it gets deleted. Next, we would build a path from S again, and this time we would run into a dead end. So we delete this vertex and continue. There are only V vertices in the graph, so we can't run into more than V dead ends, and every augmentation deletes the bottleneck edge, so we can't delete more than E edges. Overall, then, we won't try more than E paths. This process, however, of building the path by first in the adjacency list, and then augmenting at or deleting a vertex as appropriate, each time that set of operations is done, only costs us order V time. So overall then, we're doing order V work, order E times. So overall, this work takes order V times E. Taking this all together then, we have V phases, and each one of the individual phases costs order E times V time, for a total of E times V squared time overall, which is an improvement over Edmonds Karp.